What's up? Phil Britton here from Martial Arts Business Success, and we have got a cracker episode for you here today. We're Teema, the Institute of Martial Arts, and we got Graham here as well.
Guys, look, today's a really great topic that myself and Phil have discussed at length together, but we're going to share it with you guys, and it's called, well, GSD, Get Shit Done. And it's something that, you know, may sound easy, but to be honest with you, when you talk to anybody in your personal life and even business life, they talk about being busy. But we don't want to be busy, we want to be productive. So Phil, take it away. What do we start with first?
Well, yeah, you know, look, I think one of the, probably the biggest things that most business owners do is they are busy all the time, but not productive. Mm. That's probably one of the easiest ways to fail in business is that you feel like you're spotting flies, you know, or herding cats. And we all know what that's like as martial arts instructors, you know, with teaching little kids. Herding cats is really, really hard to do. And the same thing applies when with your list and things to do and being productive. Where, you know, there's always 101 things to do. You're never going to get away from that. And when you think you've mastered one thing, there's always something else. So I think the key is to making sure that you've got your list or lists that you do. How you're going to navigate through that list is really going to set yourself up for success. And have you, at the end of the year, go, yep, that was really productive. I had this, 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 and I'm at this point in my business, rather than going, oh my God, I was so busy, but I really don't know if I've accomplished anything.
Mm. Look, I know that we have tons of things on our list, and we have multiple businesses, both from personal but also professional. So when we create a list, and I'm sure that, you know, you guys as the viewers and the listeners have probably got your own list, but how do you make it so it is a productive list that you can get things done and do them in a timely fashion? So if we start at the top of what we do, we'd get some items, and look, don't try and put 1,000 things on the list, because realistically, you've got to think about what is the most important pressing right now. Now, there's goals, of course, that's completely separate, but my to-do list is things I want to accomplish within a few days, a week, a couple of weeks at the most, so you can get them done and then reset some new stuff in the future. So, Phil, take it away. What do we do personally that help us to get it done?
Yeah. So again, we just came off the back of a 10-day trip in the US, and we came back with a massive list. You know, we are doing quite well. We're successful in our business. Doesn't mean we don't learn, put it that way. So we come back with a big list of maybe 50 to 100 items, so to speak. So what we do together, or we do it individually, depending on what situation you are with your business, is go categorize this list. Let's go through this and go, what is like an A-list item? What's really, really important? What would make a big difference? And the three things that I always think about, is it going to make a difference to my students? Is it going to improve them? Is it going to make a difference to my business? And then also, is it going to make some money as well? So, you know, you don't want to be chasing the dollar all the time. I really want to make sure that the decisions and, you know, the things that we're going to action is going to change the level of value and service that I have my student. Mm. Is it going to improve my business? And then also, is it going to add some money in the bottom line as well? So keep those three things in mind. So anyway, we've got our list of 50 things. I want to go through them and go, what are all my A things? You got A, B, and C items. A, B, C, A, B, C, A, B, C, that's an A, that's important. Or look, I could do that in 6 months, so that's a C. You know, this is maybe at the end of the year, you know, it's down there. So once you've had that, you've got your A's, your C's, your B's, and all that sort of stuff, then you want to itemize the A's. So if we have 10 A's, we want to be able to go, well, that's what's the most important out of those 10? That one there, A1. What's second? A2, A3, A4, A5. And then what you want to do is break it all the way down to, what are my top five? Out of my 1, 2, 3, yep, 4, 5, this is what I'm going to attack this week. And even to the point where, you know, we all have these trusty phones. There are plenty of apps out there like Trello and Evernote you can use. But all iPhones come with reminders, and I set different lists, and then I have a to do it now. And then I've got my five things that I must do. And that way it's front of mind. So when I sit down at my desk, one of the worst things we do, we get to just go, what am I going to do now? We always gravitate to what we want to do, not what we should do or have to do. Mm. So this keeps me true to what I have to do. So I open that up and go, ah, that's at the top. I've got to attack that now, or go to here. So that's how I do it. That's how we do it. And that gives us great results with being productive and not just busy.
Hey guys, just a really great tip too with tackling those big items. Now, I know that, you know, if referencing back to our trip away, we know we've got some major things that we're tackling. So when we put that as an A item, we know that we can't complete that in a day, a week, a month, whatever it may be, but it allows us to set some time aside to start that. So for example, we may put an hour aside on doing some curriculum or a change to our systems, whatnot. It's still front of mind. It's still something that needs to be done this week or that day, but we know that it's not going to be completed wholeheartedly. So it's important though to really sort of understand, what am I doing to help create that momentum, be productive, as we said, and just not sort of leave it to the last minute.
Yeah. Graham, I'm probably going to cut you off here and say the same thing. But we talked about A, B, C. There's the next letter, which is
D. So delegate. This is a tough one. This is something that you don't learn easily. How do you let go? How do you let your emotions go and actually let somebody else do that work?
Like if someone's really good at like hooking up an extension cord or something. You know,
like. Look, it's one of those things where you do need to make sure that, you know, you find the right person that can step in and help you out. But look, in all honesty, delegating. Where do you start? How do you let go of the items that are probably just cluttering your list that you don't need to do? How can you empower other people to be able to take that responsibility?
I think you just got to look at your list and be brutally honest. You know, like it comes down to those things. You know, look, you know, you talk about things that I love doing, and I really enjoy, you know, editing videos and doing all that. So I had a period of my time where I do everything. Now I still do some because I enjoy it, but I can also delegate that job to someone else. Yeah, it might not be exactly how I want it. But editing videos takes a lot of time. You know, to shoot 1 hour, you got like 7 hours of editing, you know, if you don't really know what to do. So that was something that we could delegate. Cleaning the mirrors, cleaning the mats, you know, all that sort of stuff. Photocopying, checking things, you know, like all the lower level items that just has to be done, but aren't really improving the business out of this world. I think, you know, so the D, the delegating things are things that you can delegate to someone. They're still going to get the same result, and at the worst case scenario, 80% of the 100% you could do.
Yep.
So, you know, we're big believers of 80-20. If I did the job, it would be 100%. And I'd love, you know, it's exactly how I want it done. I delegate it to Graham. Well, video editing's not Graham's strong point. He's okay at it, probably about an orange belt, you know. So he does a good job, but, you know, it's 80%, but I'm happy with that, you know. So as long as you can delegate a job, it's 80%. It gives me 20% of my time to work on a higher level activity, like a game changer activity. Then that's how we're going to delegate those jobs.
We've got another sort of level to delegating. And I suppose it's not necessarily your low level sort of little cleaning jobs. Let's talk about marketing or creating some material like flyers and bits and pieces and stuff like that. I guess we've chatted before. You got to know enough to be dangerous. But do you need to master every sort of skill there? I guess not. And myself and Phil, for example, know, you know, various things within our business. We know a lot about, you know, a few little bits and pieces there that we have, but we certainly do delegate those job roles to professionals that can do them in a time frame and give us the maximum return on investment without having to do it. Like we talked about, you know, using the example of video editing. 7 hours to do video, geez, you know, and that's an amateur. What of a professional? It may take them only a fewer hours to do the same result. So, you know, for you as a business owner, when you're looking at delegating a job role, think of, okay, what time will it cost me? What's the cost, the hidden cost, both time, wages, frustration, you know, procrastination on other tasks that are probably more important. So it is important to make sure that you guys are appreciative and understand that. But we've got, I guess, once you've delegated a task, what's the next thing that we need to be doing just to make sure that it meets the standard that you're looking for?
Well, after our trip through the States, we met a great guy, Zulfi from Bushy Bun. Amazing guy, been in the game for a long, long time, some great schools, great skills, wealth of knowledge. And he had a quote, you know, I know you're the king of quotes, but I think Zulfi had a few, which is pretty cool. A quote off, which, you know, if you know Graham, he's pretty competitive with his quotes. I'll let you dish that one out.
Look, it was one that really stuck with me, which is why I bring it up. And it was like, inspect what you expect. And really what that is you delegate something, don't set and forget. Or assume that it's been done to your standards. Make sure that you do go and follow up on that or follow up on the task. Now, do you need to follow up on everything? Probably not, but if you do start to get into a habit of delegating to staff members, make sure they know the boss is not just going to let it go. Go and check that they're doing it to the level that you expect, the standard that you want. Or again, if you've delegated, they haven't reached that mark, how do you then obviously train them so they're at the same level? So again, you know, that quote, it's really important, inspect what you expect. It's a gem, something we apply in our business on a regular basis, but geez, it's a really productive one there for you guys.
I'm going to give you one more unlock. So we got A, B, C's, we got D's, which is delegate. man, there's going to be things on your list, eliminate. Eliminate it. Like, it's just a time waster.
Yep.
You don't need it to be on your list. It's just one of those things that stays there for 12 months, 18 months, 24 months. You know, eliminate it. Get it off your list, because every time you look at it, makes your list look bulky.
I was going to cut in and just basically summarize with you guys. That's what we do. We talk over each other all the time. But look, and honestly, guys, we say it. If you want to get this stuff done, okay, you want to get shit done, you've got to do it. You've got to apply it. You cannot just listen to it and then do nothing with it. So my challenge to you guys is really start making your list, make your ABCs, Ds and Es in there, and get to it.
All right, gang. Well, I just want a big shout out after our America trip. Shout out to all our friends that we've met over there, all the USA guys, UK guys, people all over the world that we met. It was fantastic, very friendly, open-hearted. I think one of those things, gang, is you just got to get out of your backyard, travel around, get your lists, and just nut through it. So if you guys want some help with your list and want help with your business, that's what we're here for, to give you great advice, tips, tricks, and strategies on how we've done it. And you can get that access online and do it yourself, or you can hire us as your coaches, as your mentors, to help hold your hand and push you to excel and be the best business owner and best person that you can be. So if that's interesting of you guys, shoot us a line, admin@teamer.com.au, leave a comment, a reply, we're here to help. So have a fantastic week, gang, and go get them.
Take care.
Teamer, innovating martial arts industry.